Dear students, welcome to our YouTube channel Vidya for Success. In this video, let us continue our study on the anatomy of earthworm. So already we have discussed regarding the digestive system, excretory system, as well as the morphology of earthworm, right? So we understood how the digestion takes place in the earthworm and how the excretion takes place in the worm. And next we are going to study about the reproductive system of earthworm, right? So let us understand here how the earthworm is going to produce the younger ones. So earthworm is hermaphrodite animal. So what do you mean by hermaphrodite? So hermaphrodite is nothing but bisexual animal. That means both the sexes are present in the same animal. So the male sex organ as well as a female sex organ are present in the same animal. So because of this, it is called as hermaphrodite. So it is not like a human being. So in the human being, we can see the male individual produces male gamete and female individual produces female gamete, right? But in case of earthworm, the testes and ovary, so these are the reproductive organs. So both these reproductive organs are present in the same worm. So it is a hermaphrodite, right? And let us focus on the male reproductive system of the earthworm. So in the diagram, I have labeled the number of organ present in the male reproductive system. So male reproductive system consists of testes, seminal vesicle, vasa differentia, then prostatic gland, and common prostatic and spermatic duct. So these are the few organs can be seen in the male reproductive system. So what is the function of male reproductive system? So male reproductive system produces male gamete, right? So the one organ what we can see in the male reproductive system is testes. So there are two pairs of testes are present in the earthworm. So each pair of testes are located within a testicular sac. So you can observe in the diagram. So in the 10th as well as in the 11th segment, we can see the testicular sac. A sac-like structure will be present. So within that sac-like structure, we have a pair of testes. So in the 10th segment, we have testicular sac. Within that, we have a pair of testes. In the same way, the 11th segment also consists of testicular sac. Within that sac, we have a pair of testes. So that two pair of testes are present in the male reproductive system. So what is the function of testes? So testes is the main organ where the formation of male gamete takes place. So that male gamete produces within the testes, right? And just below the testes, we have a seminal vesicle, right? You can observe in the diagram. The seminal vesicle is also a sac-like structure. So there are pair of seminal vesicle can be seen in each of the segment. So the testes present in the 10th segment, they are connected with a pair of seminal vesicle. In the same way, the testes present in the 11th segment are also connected with the sac-like structure, pair of sac-like structure. They are known as seminal vesicles, right? So what is the function of seminal vesicle? Why they are get connected to the testes? So testes produces male gamete, right? So as soon as they produces, they migrate to the seminal vesicle because it is the place where the male gametes are stored temporarily. So seminal vesicle is the organ where the temporary storage of male gamete takes place. And one more organ we can see here is vasa differentia. So vasa differentia is a tube-like structure. So we can see the vasa differentia arises or they are connected with the testes, right? So on each of the side, pair of vasa differentia arises. So they are connected with the testes, right? So why these tubular structures are connected with the testes? What is the function of this vasa deferentia? So vasa deferentia helps in the carrying the male gamete towards the genital pore, right? So vasa deferentia is a tubular structure. It carry the male gamete towards the duct. Understood? So this structure will run up to 18 segment. So why it is running up to the 18 segment? Because in the 18 segment, male genital pore is present. So that it runs up to the 18 segment where it joins with the prostate gland. Then the one more organ is accessory glands. So there are two pairs of accessory glands are present in the earthworm. So one pair of accessory gland is present in the 17th segment. You can see the dark colored circular structure in the 7th segment. They are in pair, right? So those structures are nothing but accessory glands. And it is also present in the 19th segment. So in the 17th as well as in the 19th segment, there are pair of glands are present. Those pair of glands are called as accessory glands. So what is the function of these glands? So glands are always secretory in their function. They secrete some fluid, right? So these glands secrete some fluid during the time of copulation. That means when the two worms, they come in contact with each other during the copulation. So at that time, the accessory glands secrete some of the fluid so that two worms, they come in contact with one another. So they properly fix with one another because of the fluid secreted by the accessory gland, right? So this is the function of this gland. And the one more organ what we can see is the one more organ of the male reproductive system is prostatic and spermatic duct. So why it is called as prostatic and spermatic duct? Because this duct is connected to the prostatic gland as well as the same duct helps in the ejection of sperm from the body. So because both the fluids, that means the spermatic fluid as well as the prostatic fluid, they eject out through the same duct, it is called as common prostatic and spermatic duct. So this duct opens to the exterior by a pair of male genital pore. So this duct is actually get open to the outside. So on the 18th segment, we know on the ventrolateral side, there are pair of openings are present. So those openings are named as male genital pore, right? So male genital pore is not actually present towards the middle region of the earthworm. It is present towards the lateral side. So on the ventrolateral region, on the 18th segment, the pair of male genital pores are present. So these male genital pores are connected with the prostatic and spermatic duct. So that this duct ejects the sperm as well as the some fluid secreted from the prostatic duct. And the one more very important organ we need to understand in the reproductive male reproductive system is spermatheca. So spermatheca are the pair of structure. So we can see this structure from 6th segment to till the 9th segment. So from 6th to till 9th segment, a pair of structures are present in the earthworm. So these pair of structures are called as spermatheca. So totally there are 4 pairs of spermatheca are present. So what is the function of these structure? Why they are present in the earthworm? So these are the structure needed by the earthworm for receiving male gamete. So even though it is a hermaphrodite animal, the mating of male and female gamete does not takes, that means the exchange of male and female gamete does not takes place within the same individual. So it receive the male gamete from the one more worm. So because of this, the earthworm needs some of the structure. So those structures are nothing but spermatheca. So spermatheca are the structures, they helps to receive the male gamete from the one more earthworm during the time of copulation, right? So these are the some organs what we can see in the male reproductive system, right? So let us glance all the organs what we have studied now. So the first organ present in the male reproductive system is testes. So there are pair of testes are present in 10th and 11th segment. So those pair of structures, they are covered within a sac-like structure named as testicular sac. So the function of testes is they produces male gamete. And the produced male gamete temporarily gets stored in the sac-like structure, one more sac-like structure that is called as seminal vesicle. And the testes is connected with the tubular structure that is called as vasa deferentia. So the movement of sperm towards the prostatic gland is takes place through the vasa deferentia, right? So then the sperms from the vasa deferentia migrate towards the prostatic gland. So prostatic gland is the place where some fluids are get secreted. So these fluids very essential for the movement of sperm towards the further region of the male reproductive system. So with the help of the fluid secreted by the prostatic gland, the sperm moves through the spermatic duct and finally it ejects out from the body through the male genital pore. So this is how the male reproductive system in the earthworm perform work, right? So finally the male gametes get releases out from the male reproductive system. Yes, now let us study about a female reproductive system. So female reproductive system consists of only few organs. Just you observe the diagram here. So in the diagram I have labeled the organs present in the female reproductive system. So one of the organ we have here is ovary, then next to that ovarian funnel, and one more is oviduct. So these are the different organs present in the female reproductive system of earthworm, right? So let us study about one by one. So ovary is a part of female reproductive system. So just you observe the diagram. So there are pair of ovaries are present in the earthworm. So what is the position of these structure? They are actually present in the interstitial segment of the earthworm, right? So the meaning of interstitial segment is nothing but in between the two segment. That means where the one segment get joined with the adjacent segment, in that particular region we can see a pair of ovary. So the actual position is between the 12th and 13th segment. So in the wall where the 12th segment come in contact with the 13th segment, in that particular area we have a pair of structures called as ovary, right? So what is the function of these structures? Why the ovary is present in the female reproductive system? So ovary is the organ where the formation of female gamete takes place, right? So this is the main organ where the female gamete formation taking place in the organism, right? So this pair of structures are in turn connected with one more organ called as ovarian funnel. You can just observe in the diagram, just below the ovary there is a funnel-shaped structure is present. So that funnel-shaped structure is nothing but ovarian funnel. So this is present just below the ovary. So the function of ovarian funnel is it receives the female gamete from the ovary. So as soon as the ovary releases the gamete, this funnel receives it, right? So this is the main function of ovarian funnel. So it receives the female gamete from ovary, right? So those received gametes will passes through a tubular structure called as oviduct. So oviduct is a one more organ can be seen in the female reproductive system. So this duct is actually get opened into a female genital pore on the ventral surface. So if we just observe the ventral region of the earthworm on the 14th segment on the ventral side, we can see the small genital pore, that is nothing but the female genital pore. So the oviduct is actually get opened into the female genital pore so that the eggs produced by the ovary passes through the oviduct and they actually send out from the organism through the female genital pore. Right, so oviduct is a tubular structure. This tubular structure is actually get opened into the female genital pore. So it is very essential to remove the female gamete out from the female reproductive system. Right, so one thing you need to understand here, the male reproductive system consists of a pair of genital pore. So those pair of genital pores are actually present on the ventrolateral side of 18th segment. Understood? But if you come to the female reproductive system, the only one female genital pore is present on the ventral side, right? On the 14th segment. So these are the differences between the genital pore, right? So the male reproductive system consists of a pair of genital pore, but the female reproductive system consists of a single genital pore, right? So as of now, we have understood how the formation of the male and female gamete takes place in the reproductive system. So next we need to understand how these gametes fuses together, because in order to form young ones, gametes need to be fused with one another. But one interesting thing here is, earthworm is a hermaphrodite, right? So even though it is a hermaphrodite, the gametes produced within the same animal are not undergoing fusion. Clear? Instead of that, the male gamete received from the one more worm and it fuses with the female gamete and it results in the formation of young ones. So this is very interesting thing we need to understand here. So let us continue our study with the process of reproduction. Yes, let us now understand the process of reproduction. So now we came to know that earthworm is a hermaphrodite. So even though it is a hermaphrodite, the fusion of male and female gamete produced in the same worm does not take place. So one earthworm need to search for the another earthworm for mating, right? So the first step of the process of reproduction is the exchange of spermatophores during mating. So the mating of the earthworm is called as juxtaposing, because the two earthworm come in contact with one another on the ventral side. So the anterior end of the one worm lie on the posterior end of the another worm. So this kind of mating is called as juxtaposing. So as you are observing in the diagram, in the same way, the two ventral side of the two earthworm come in contact with one another. So during their mating, they mutually exchange their spermatophores, right? What do you mean by spermatophores? So spermatophores are nothing but the pockets of sperms. So a sac-like structure will be present within that. Many sperms are there. So that is actually called as spermatophores. So during their mating, they mutually exchange their spermatophores, right? So the spermatophore, exchange spermatophore is actually get stored in the spermatheca. So we have already come across with the spermatheca, right? So spermatheca are the pair of structure. They are present from sixth segment till the ninth segment. So these are the structure they store the spermatophores after mating. So the next step is the secretion of a fluid filled tube. So the clitellum is the region, this region actually secrete a fluid filled tube around it. So we already know about the clitellum, right? So from 14th segment to 16th segment, the earthworm consists of a glandular cell. So that glandular cell started secreting some of the fluid. So that fluid forms a tubular structure around the earthworm. That means some segment of the earthworm actually covered with the fluid filled tube, right? So in the next step, the earthworm starts to move out the slime tube. So because the fluid is present in the tube, it started moving to different part of the earthworm. So earthworm just vibrates its body so that the fluid filled tube started moving towards the forward region of the earthworm, right? So the first fluid filled region move towards the female genital pore, right? So we know the female genital pore is present on the 14th segment on the ventral side. So when this slimy tube moves towards the female genital pore, it collects the egg, so that the eggs are get deposited in the slimy tube, right? And the movement of slimy tube continues further, and it later move towards the spermatheca. So we know that spermatheca is the region where the spermatophores are present. So when the fluid filled tube move towards the spermatheca region, the sperm present in that particular structure deposited to the fluid filled tube, so that within the tube we have egg as well as sperm. So the movement of the slimy tube helps in the collection of gametes from the male pore as well as from the spermatheca. And finally, when the earthworm started vibrating its body completely, that slimy tube comes out from the earthworm. Yes, as soon as the slimy tube completely separates from the worm, both sides of slimy tube get closes. So completely a protective structure will be formed as soon as it separates out from the earthworm. So that protective structure consists of egg and sperm. So that protective structure is named as cocoon. So cocoon is get deposited into the soil. So within the cocoon, the fertilization takes place. That means male and female gamete fuses with one another and finally results in the formation of embryo, right? So the cocoon consists of embryo. So after about 3 weeks, each cocoon produces 2 to 20 number of inkworms. So nearly 2 to 20 baby worms are produced from cocoon, right? So this is actually the process of reproduction. So by this process, the number of earthworm is get increased in the soil. So all the inkworms produced, they appears same like their adults, right? So what is the kind of development? So the kind of development is direct development, because there is no larval state seen in the earthworm. So because of this, the development is called as direct development. Understood? So this is about the process of reproduction. So children's process of reproduction is quite interesting to study, and it is easy to understand also. Clear? So in this concept, actually you have to practice, you should practice the diagram of reproductive system. So you have to practice the terminologies coming in male and female reproductive system with diagram, because in the examination they will ask the question for 5 marks. So many time the questions has been asked in the question paper. So you have to practice the diagram with all the terminologies. Right? Thank you.